one of my mom's favorite phrases, neither hell nor high water, was going to keep Stephanie Miller off the air here on KTLA. Her triumphant return, we love her on the radio, SiriusXM satellite radio. There's a camera on the studio all the time. These live shows are huge. It's all going your way.
Well, and listen, you know you've hit the zenith of your career when you get bumped by a woman driving a stolen U-Haul.
There it is.
So and you thought I'd never make anything of myself, right. Mom.
So we give you good fodder for tomorrow.
This is really the highlight of my career. I feel a woman driving a stolen U-Haul is like there's so many lesbian jokes in that. I don't even know where to start.
There it is, yes.
I should come clean on KTLA. I was my girlfriend. I broke up with her this morning. She was going to pick up my stuff. I apologize.
All right. There we go from there to this. You've got this live show happening, but you can't go because it's already sold out. You've had great success. You call it the Sexy Liberal Tour?
Stephanie Miller's Sexy Liberal Resistance Tour.
Okay.
It is sold out this Saturday at the Mark Taper Forum, but the last one is December 9th in San Francisco at the Herbst Theater. This Saturday, Rob Reiner and Representative Ted Lieu will join us on panel. And it is the Donald Trump Resistance Tour is what it is.
And let me ask you about that. Has the fact that there's such an obvious foil been good for the Stephanie Miller business?
As I mentioned, the show is sold out. Do you all have PTSD from your phone alerts? You're just like, oh, what did he do now? Oh, my God.
But here's the thing. You're very politically minded. You have a very political point of view. And you're also a comic.
Yes.
As a comic, is this all good?
As a comic, it's fantastic. As an American, it is a dystopian nightmare from which there is no waking.
All right. Rush Limbaugh and other names that we know are very prominent in conservative radio. And there's always been this thing that the left has never had an equivalently loud voice. Is that the right?
Someone on as much OxyContin. Is that what you were looking for?
Maybe that a minute.
I apologize.
Right. No. But what about that? Do you think that's...
Well, I think that it's not just me.
Right.
Saturday Night Live is having their highest ratings. Stephen Colbert. I mean, I think that if you're looking at Trump's polling numbers and indictments rolling in and, you know, the election that just happened this week, I think there's a lot of Americans that are agreeing with us and are horrified and embarrassed by him.
How did you feel the day after the election? And what was your show like on that day?
I was not sober, so I don't remember. Okay. But if I did, I would tell you. It's been a year of day drinking,
your show on KFI was when?
1,000 years ago, we were on Janus.
But here's the thing. I mean,
in the 90s.
Right, but to your credit, you have kept at it.
Yes. Yes, isn't that? Well, I would never have made it to get bumped by a stolen truck chase.
What is the ebook Sexy Liberal of Me I Sing?
It is my number one book that's been on Amazon, and it's an ebook and also out in paperback by popular demand. It is the book form, Sexy Liberal of Me I Sing. And next year, I'm going to be part of a brand new news network that will be geared to the left. I will be the face of it.
Okay.
Sam.
would it be to the left of MSNBC?
I feel like the left is such an interesting, my dad ran for vice president with Barry Goldwater,
right.
And this Republican Party is no longer, my sister, who was a Goldwater girl, just sent me Tom Steyer's sign the impeach Donald Trump petition. So I feel like this is not only not my dad and Goldwater's party, I don't know what the left means anymore. I think right now it means people that are sane, that don't want to be shot to death, that would like health care. I mean, I don't even know that this is partisan so much anymore.
Are we splintering more and more? And that's because the major parties to a degree are...
I think so. I'm going to have Thanksgiving with my 94-year-old Republican Trump-voting Fox News-watching mom, and that'll be fun.
What does she think of her daughter?
This is exactly what she said. She said, oh, well, dear, that'll be so nice. Of course I love you. I don't approve. I don't know why you have to work so blue. and also, she said, Donald Trump, he loves this country. He's just doing the best he can. I was like, okay.
Now,
after the impeachment.
Do you try to make it to dessert before you talk about it? Or pumpkin pie?
We don't
pie
talk
first?
About it anymore.
Okay.
But I honestly, the serious thing I will say is I think Fox News has honestly been a cancer on this country because... Most people, I think, have lost someone, a family member, a friend or something, because we used to have two sets of facts and then we disagreed on what policy should be. I mean, I spend the whole conversation going, but well, that's just not true, Mom. Like, that's just, Hillary did not run
right.
A pedophile ring out of a pizza
parlor. Here, I'll tell you this. Stephanie Miller's Sexy Liberal Resistance Tour, the forum date at the Mark Tabor is sold out. Tickets for one date in San Francisco. Frangela, our friends of ours, John Fugelsang as well. Sexyliberal.com, the website. Stephanie, on your satellite radio, on your cable, just about everywhere. Nice to see you this morning.
In your random U-Haul truck.
Right, there you go. Thanks.
Thanks, Stephanie.
Thanks.